आज भी अतीब सुंदर
So there's such a beautiful and pure day today. Today, so in this auspicious occasion, we are here together today. So there's the Ganga Dasahar. In the evening, we'll discuss about Ganga Dasahar. Especially, today is also the disappearance of Baladev Vidyabhushan Prabhu. Today is also the Tirubhavar Vibhavar of Ganga Mata Goswamini. So we'll discuss all this katha today. So I'm thinking that today we'll discuss a little bit about the Manashiksha. Because we stopped in the 9th shloka. So let's read the Manashiksha now. So I couldn't finish the 9th shloka of the Manashiksha. So Gurudev is going for Manashiksha. So yesterday also we heard about this 9th shloka of the Manashiksha. How the Raganuga Sadhak performing bhajan slowly. Page 86 in the Manashiksha English. The devotee he enters Sabishta Bhavmoy Sadhan. Because in Raganuga Sadhana there are five times of symptoms of Raganuga Sadhana. One is Bhavamaya Sadhana. Second, Bhava Sambandhi Sadhana, Bhava Anukul Sadhana, Bhava Pratikul, and Bhava Aviruddha. So these five like limbs of Raganuga Sadhana. So first, Bhavamaya Sadhana. When the sadhaka performs bhajan, he will choose one special mood. So the other bhavas, they are just nourishing that one bhava. He accepts the only bhavas, just the other bhavas, just for nourishing. Pushtikaraka means to nourishment. To nourishment the other bhavas. But you choose one bhava, like you fix one mood. Just like the pole star. You know the pole star? Is in the star. In the north, always shining, the pole star, always shining on the north. Since ancient times, those who are going by boat, by ship in the ocean, those who are traveling by, ship in the ocean, they used to see this Dhruva Tara, means the north pole star, and they used to guide themselves in the seas, because at that time, they were not, like the compass still wasn't not there, and all these things for navigation. So the captains of the ships, they would guide themselves according to this north, this star which is always in the north, which is called Dhruva, North Pole, Pole Star, sorry. So other stars, they may change position, other constellations, they may change position in the sky, but the Dhruva Tara, this Pole Star, is always in the same place, always in the north. And shining so much also. So in the same way, the sadhaka, when he goes, when he starts his bhajan, like I explained, the bhavmay sadhan of Raganuga Bhakti. Dasa Sakavatsale Madhurja. So keeping this Madhura Bhava in your like a fixed mode you want to attain, then you continue. So doing bhajan slowly, the sadhana will become the sadhya. The sadhana will appear as your sadhya. So first we follow like the sadhana, but then slowly, the more we'll be free from the anarthas, Then we'll realize our swarupa, spiritual form. Then slowly, slowly, we'll attain our goal. So, this bhavamay sadhan, later on, it transforms in sadhya, into your goal itself. So, for the first few days, we've been discussing all this. And the five kinds of sadhana of Raganuga Bhakti. So, here in the ninth sloka of the Manushiksha, Srila Das Goswami is explaining, my only mistress, Isha means Swamini, my mistress, who is she? Srimati Radhika. So one thing is here, Madhyatva Bhav. So your bhajana sadhana, in your bhajana sadhana, you always have to care about two important things, Madhyatva Bhav and Tadvaita Bhav. Tadvaita Bhav means I belong to him. And Madhyatva Bhav means he is mine. He is mine. So in this situation, there is more possessiveness. If you think he belongs to me, this is more possessiveness than I belong to him. So, like in this world also, because of ahangata and mamata, like identity and possessiveness, everyone, like, the first ahankara, like ego, identity is like with this body, the hatma body. I'm the body. I'm the doer of this action. I, me. So, this is ahankara. Me, like I and I and me and me and I. Who is like doing me, like I? Is the... She goat. In this world, we're always like, I've done this, I've done that. But if something happens, then you don't have any potency to do anything else, and God is laughing at you. Those who are always like, I've done this, I've done that, and Bhagavan is only laughing at them. Oh. So, that day I told that story about the end of the Mahabharata war. Remember I told you guys about the story of Barbari, wasn't it? I told you. Barbari told to the Pandavas, you're like, means I've done that. Because the five Pandavas were thinking, if it wouldn't be for us, this Mahabharata war would never even have taken place. They were thinking, I was, like Arjuna said, I've done this, I killed him and killed that Bhima also, I've killed alone all these 100 sons of the Dhritarashtra, I've done everything. So they were bragging, you know. All of them, the Pandavas. Then Bhagavan took them to see this Babarik. It was one person who had only his head cut out, chopped off, like head separated from body, so only the head was there. So the Babarik told, I'll tell you the truth, I was observing the war, and I saw that no one did a thing in this war. Everyone, all of you, were just the agents of the action, but actually who was doing everything was Krishna. Like, you were only like the external, like, medium of the action, but actually Krishna did everything, I saw. In this way, all the pride of the Pandavas were destroyed. So, in this world, ahangata, this identity we have so much, this ego. And also, another thing we have in this world is mamata, this possessiveness, mine. So ahangata and mamata, identity and possessiveness. So this world is like this. I have so much attachment. So in the spiritual world, there are also ahangata and mamata in the spiritual world, but they are transcendental. Like for example, Nanda Yashoda, they say, Krishna is my son. Right? I am Nanda Maharaj. This is ahangata, like identity. So there is spiritual identity and material identity. This is the only difference. Because actually, this material world, everything we see in this material world, it's a perverted reflection from the spiritual world. Perverted reflection of the transcendental world. Whatever we see in this world, so, in this world, in that world, there is also ahangata mamata, identity and possessiveness, but in a pure state, pure form. But the ahangata mamata that we see in this world is bikrit, means perverted. What is bikrit? perverted. It's like a reflection of the pure state of things. Like a reflection, like a perverted reflection. It's not actually true. It isn't actually true. So imagine you're sitting in front of a mirror. And then you start eating in front of the mirror, okay? You start to eat something. You eat with your right hand, right? So you eat with the left hand or right? Right. But in the mirror, it will appear as like you're eating with your left hand, you know, but actually you're eating with your right. So the mirror will give the perverted reflection. The opposite what is actually going on is what will appear in the mirror. Or maybe you'll see yourself fat or thin, slim. This also sometimes this depends on the kind of mirror. There are many kinds of mirror. There's some mirrors that make you thinner, some mirrors make you fatter. I forgot, but how do they say this? Many kinds of mirrors. So maybe one kind of mirror you see your body very beautiful. Another mirror you will see yourself very thin. Hey, concavo, I don't know the names. Uttal, I don't know English names or these terms, depending on which kind of long, many days ago I studied this, so I forgot. These I also don't know English terms, but these kinds of lenses that they give different result, right? So how to know your real form? Actually, this world is a perverted reflection from the spiritual world. A perverted reflection, like suppose, just like a yogurt is a transformation of the milk. That potency which is in the milk is also in the yogurt, doesn't change, but it is shown in a different way, the potency which is in the yogurt. Another point. The milk transforms itself and becomes yogurt, but the yogurt can never again become milk. This is something amazing. So what I want to say with all this is that ahangata and mamata, identity and possessiveness, in this world, so everywhere there is ahangata, this identity and mamata, this possessiveness, but in this world, it is seen in a perverted way. Continuing. So why I'm saying this? Because this loka is saying, Madisha, my mistress. Who is my mistress? Madisha in Sanskrit. Mad means mine, you know, in Sanskrit. Madisha, my mistress, Ishimati Radhika. Isha means? Isha is a feminine gender for Ishwar, for controller. So Ishwar, Ishwari. So the Swarupa Shakti Swarupuni, the personification of the potency of Lord, Shrimati Radhika. She is my Ishwari, my controller, my mistress. Isha we use in many ways, like when our father passes away, we also use this word Isha, means like he passed away. I don't know how do you write here. So after the father passes away, we say, like we write in near his name, like Swargavasi or other terms that meant he passed away. Swargiya Mata Pita, like my deceased parents. Sometimes they put on in the front of the names of the parents that had passed away. Different traditions of showing how the parents passed away. Sometimes Ishwar also they write, means they attain to God. That's why they write like this before the names. So I'm explaining this because Ishwara and Ishwari. So, who is my Ishwari? My mistress, controller Shrimati Radhika. The verbal root Isha means to control, the supreme controller. Ishdhatu, the verbal root Ish. In the feminine gender is Ishwari. Who इज माई ईश्वरी श्रीमती राधिका. हु इज द लॉर्ड ऑफ माई कंट्रोलर मीन्स नॉट सॉरी नाथ कैन मीन एक्चुअली लाइक बिलव्ड प्रिय डियर. हु इज द बिलव्ड ऑफ माई मिस्ट्रेस व्रज विपिन चंद्रन कृष्ण. This Krishna means, so the meaning of this, Raghunatha Goswami is saying, my Ishwar is Srimati Radhika. She's mine, not yours. So this shows so much possessiveness. Not, she's not yours, she's mine. So this is Madhita Bhav, she's mine. And Tadita Bhav is like, I belong to her, to him. So in Ujjalanilamani, Rupa Goswami, he defines Sneha. And he told, one thing is Gita Sneha, affection like the ghee, and Madhu Sneha, affection like the honey. Gita Sneha is like more worshipable, like more respectable, better than the Gita, Sneha, the affection like the ghee. So why the affection like the honey is better than like the ghee? So first let's understand about ghee and the honey. Honey and ghee, both are very delicious substance and healthy substances, honey and ghee, both. Both are good for the body, are healthy foodstuffs, ghee and honey. But in the ghee, doesn't have its own taste. Like if you take the pure ghee and you put it in your tongue, actually you won't feel any kind of special taste. Is it sweet or what, bitter or what? Like no taste. No, it's good. Yeah, it's good, but from a pure cow. So this ghee from a pure cow. You melt it and you take one drop in your tongue. You like it. It tastes nice, but is it sweet or what is it? Is it bitter? What is it? You just know you like it, but you don't, it's nice, tasty, but not a specific taste. But Madhu, you just take a drop and so sweet, isn't it? So immediately you say it's sweet, it's something certainly sweet, isn't it? Another point. So the ghee sometimes also it changes nature. Like in the summertime, the ghee melts. So when it's hot, immediately the ghee melts, you know? But if it's cold, the ghee becomes, in the jar, it will become like frozen, like a solid, isn't it? Solid. So, according to the circumstance, the ghee will change its nature or his, like, means solid or liquid, according to the climate. But the honey, whether it's hot or cold weather, in colder weather, it does not change. Is at the ease and become and continues what it is. Like now it's summertime, so you see when, like some beehive, you find the honey also in the beehive in the summertime. This is the speciality of the honey. The honey remains sweet, it doesn't change, never. So, but if you mix some ingredients in the ghee, then the ghee becomes gets really tasty. So the ghee is called Upadhyaya Raja. What? Like in the ancient times. I didn't understand. What? Sorry? I don't know if you know or not. But when the new daughter-in-law used to come to the house in Bengal, There was a big party at the time for celebration. So in Bengal they call Bahubad. This is a tradition of Bengal. So because the new daughter-in-law came to the house, so they make a big party in the house. They call all the people, everyone. There's a big party celebration. They cook many kinds of sabjis. You know how in Bengal, when there's a party, they don't even count. They cook so many preparations. And there's... So ghee bhag, this is also called. Ghee bhat. So to relish the ghee, you have to mix some ingredients, like some little bit sugar, like fine sugar, and also some salt, some camphor, cardamom, black pepper, little bit, not so much, just little bit of these ingredients. Then you mix them. And you can eat the ghee with rice, then it'll be very tasty. So if you put only this ghee bag in the rice, it won't be so tasty. But if you mix all these ingredients, you have to mix according to the proportion in the ghee. According to the proper proportion, you have to mix. Then it'll be very tasty. So this is in the culture of ancient India. It's called ghee bhat. Like the great kings, they used to do these things. They used to do this. I didn't understand exactly, I'm sorry, the translator, but maybe they were in these celebrations also distributing ghee, and everybody was taking the ghee also with the food, like this. Means, I want to say that the ghee has not taste on its own, but when you mix with something else, then it becomes tasty. And ghee is very healthy. Make your body really strong. And but if you take a lot of honey, your body will be very hot. Our Krishna Das, once, he took so much honey, and during the night he could not even sleep. He became really crazy because of the honey. Because if you really lick a lot of honey, your body will be really hot. Like it will make your body really hot. That's why the Vedic daughters, generally they give the anupam with the ghee. With the honey. Like those who are weak or something, they have to take the medicines with the honey. Generally, they tell the person to mix the medicines with honey. Also use honey also in the worship of God. Ghee, of course, also used in the worship. You know, the Panchamrita, the five ingredients. Honey and ghee are also there. Without these two ingredients, you cannot bathe the deity. But if you don't have the ingredients, at least with the mantra, you have to tell the names of these substances for the Abhishek, for bathing the deity. So what I want to say is Grita Sneha, one kind of affection, and another Madhu Sneha. Affection like the ghee and affection like the honey. But Gita Sneha, like the ghee, has Tadeta Bhav. I belong to him. And Madhu Sneha, affection like the honey, Madeta Bhav is there. He belongs to me. So gopis and Shrimati Radhika from group, Shrimati Radhika is a group, they have Madhu Sneha. Krishna belongs to me. But Chandravali and her friends, they have Tadeta Bhava. I belong to him. Sometimes the acharyas also explain. Maybe they have some Adeta Bhava, but not so much. But generally they have, like the queens of Dwarka, they have Tadeta Bhava. They think they belong to Krishna. Like the wives of Krishna in Dwarka, they think that they belong to Krishna. I am Krishna's wife. So they are like, they have that bhav. I belong to him. But in Braj, they think Krishna is my beloved. So see how different. Krishna is my pranpriyatam. He is my pranpriyatam, my dear beloved, topmost dear beloved of my life, my life here. So, it's not that they don't have Madhyata Bhav, but they generally have more Tadhyata Bhav. Why? Because according to the Vedas and the culture, the ladies, they must depend on the husband, right? Wife have to depend on her husband. So, that's why it's normal to feel the Tadhyata Bhav, like I belong to him. Like I do according to my husband's instructions. And but in Parakya Bhav, Paramur mood, no, he must do as I tell, like, isn't it? I didn't know if you understand. Yesterday I spoke. Jamana chata deke. So this song I spoke yesterday is a kirtan they sing in the time of wedding ceremony. There's all some tadi above in this. What is the Hindi meaning? The devotee is asking. Hindi, Bengali and mixed, it's one. But what is the meaning? The devotee insists. Hindi and Bengali is one thing. You don't understand the meaning. Swahag means like this, the sindur, and many symbols they put, and this bangles, like the wife is so beautiful, the bride, she's so beautiful. How will I dance? Yeah, now this is Bengali. So this fakir, like you have to dance according to your husband desires. Mr. D above. No, this wife will belong to the husband. So this first fakir, but in Parakya is opposite. Then it's the opposite in Parakya, Paramurmud. Rai means the woman. In the ancient Bengali, in the ancient literature, Bengali literature, they used to use the word Rai for woman. To explain the root of this use, Rai, I have to go really deep. I studied this in the school, in the university. Actually, it was a title before. So there are 5 or 6 titles given at the time. Like, I forgot now. Sarkar, Vishwas, Das, Bhomik, Basak. There were some titles given at that time. So the Bengali literature, all this is described. I had to study this in details, but I'm not going further now. So first I'll dance according to his desire, but later the opposite. Look how beautiful is the bride. Continuing, so we're discussing Tadaita Madaita Bhav. One is Grita Sneha and another Madhu Sneha. So in this sloka, in the ninth sloka of the Madhu Shiksha book, Raghunatha Das Goswami, he is expressing his wonderful bhav to the lotus feet of Srimati Radhika. What is he saying? Srimati Radhika is mine. Madhisha, she's my mistress. My Swamini is only Srimati Radhika. Sorry. So this is the mood, the bhav. So he, pati means, pati doesn't mean only husband, no. Means somebody who protects, who nourishes the love of our heart, who protects our love. It is also called pati, like Jagat Pati. Who is the keeper of the, maintainer of the universe, Jagannath? That one who nourishes our love, protects our love. He's the pati, like husband, but it doesn't mean my husband necessarily. So my Swamini Srimati Radhika. So Srimati Radhika, she's my mistress, and her beloved is Braj Bipina Chandram. Vrindavana Chandra Shri Krishna, who is always performing pastimes in the Vipinas. So that's why Rupa Goswami, he wrote that Keshavashtaka. That's the Keshavashtaka, one prayer of Rupa Goswami. What is it now? So it's in the Keshavashtaka. Beautiful Bhavs explains.
जो सदा सर्वदा करते हैं अभिनव कदंब मंजरी द्वारा कर्णभूषण विकसित मालती.
I worship Keshav, who returns from the forest of Vraj, with his ears beautified with earrings made of fresh kadamba buds, whose crown is brightened by blooming malati flowers, and around whose neck a wreath of slightly blooming utica flowers is wound. After grazing the cows in the sunset time, twilight, Krishna comes back from cow grazing back to Braj. At that time, Krishna is so beautiful, his form is so beautiful, so gorgeous. Krishna is all king. Some cows, like not all cows are same or equal, so some cows they start to run here and there. Then Krishna, to gather this cow who went astray, Krishna has to run behind this cow. And at that time, so here Goswami describes his form. Krishna is using the garland given by the gopis. Still, until now, Krishna is still using it. And this flower, garland flower is so beautiful. And Krishna is running behind the cows with a stick on his hand and running after the cows. And all the hair of Krishna like scatters, and the earrings that Krishna uses, his ornaments of his ears, they're almost falling down. And it's so beautiful. It's like like the earring is not proper inside the holes of the ear. So, because when Krishna is cow grazing, he's running, so he's like, he's running fast behind the cows. Krishna is running behind the cows. So his earrings, they open up. They're almost falling down. And so that garland that Krishna has, Krishna is thinking, I don't want my garland to fall down. So to protect his garland, Krishna with his left arm, Krishna is holding his garland. With the right hand, Krishna has the stick, and with the left hand, Krishna is holding his garland so as not to fall down. And sometimes his the flute, Krishna puts like in his waist area. But when Krishna is running very quick, that garland is completely like just like a Brahmana boy. His sacred thread. In the same way. Do you understand? Like the garland falls, doesn't stay in the right position. It stays like a sacred thread. The garland is like trespassing Krishna's torso, just like a sacred thread, not like a normal garland. Generally, the garland is like in front, like straight, right? But when Krishna is running, so as not to fall down, Krishna puts the garlands like in like transversal in his torso. If the sacred thread is like in the transversal of your torso, cannot fall down. But if it's like in front, then maybe only straight can fall down. So Krishna's garland is so beautiful. It looks like Krishna is going so absorbed, so much absorbed in bhav. All these explanations are there. At that time, in the twilight time, when Krishna is coming back after cow grazing, so beautiful Krishna is in this moment. Chalo. So, who is the Vrindavaneshwari? Controller of Vrindavan is Srimati Radhika. So, Srimati Radhika is my mistress. And Lalita Ji, she is the peerless friend of my Swamini. So, this mood you must have. Among the Asta Sakis, two Sakis are very special, Lalita Vishak. They are like always in the right and left side of Srimati Radhika. So the eight Sakis, they are always, of course, topmost worshipable, yes. But even though, Lalita and Vishaka, they are most prominent, you know. So Lalita, she's the peerless friend, incomparable friend of my friend, of my mistress, Srimati Radhika. So the speciality of Lalita. Lalita, what is she doing? She's actually chastising everyone and like bossing around. She chastises everyone. Like the eight Sakis, all the Sakis, they have different moods. Each of them. Actually, each of the eight Sakis, they represent one of special mood of Srimati Radhika, actually. Each of them is one bhav personified. One of Srimati Radhika's personified bhavas. So who is Lalita Sakhi? She is one bhava mudri expression, like she's one direct expression of one mood of Srimati Radhika, Lalita. The Rasika Acharyas also describe and explain that Srimati Radhika has the eight Sakis, there are eight modes of the heroine. Which bhavas, for example? That one, a heroine who is going to meet her beloved. Abhisarika, Naika. So many kinds of modes of heroines. Naika, you know? So, Abhisarika, Vasas, Sarjika, Kandita, Vipralabda, in the end, Sadina Bhartina Naika. Anyway, just listen, this is enough. So these eight moods of the heroine, actually, they manifest each one in one sakhi specifically. These eight sakhis of Srimati Radhika. Do you understand? So the specialty of Lalita Sakhi, our acharyas have described the specialty of Lalita. Lalita, she's the best among all the sakhis. First, she's the older, and also she's the oldest, sorry, and she's also Prakara. She's very talkative. She's really like expert in speaking. Like seeing her, even Krishna becomes afraid of her. She frightens Krishna as well. Sometimes Rupa Goswami has told that sometimes when Krishna starts playing with Srimati Radhika, like then Krishna sees Lalita coming, and he tells Subhashidam, let's get out of here because Lalita is here, she chastises us. And so Krishna sees Lalita and he becomes afraid many times because Lalita is very strong and like talkative, you know, she really like. Imposes, like she's. Krishna, Lalita ko dekhkar ke kabhi bhi dar jaati hai, dar jaati hai. Lagta hai. Drishte bhajandra tanya, ma dakshina bhava, kalangini. Laga baya. So, in the Lalita Ashtakam, we see this explanation. Page 89, verse 4. So Lalita Devi also chastised Srimati Radhika, training her and chastising her. This is actually because of love. That person who can chastise you, who can give discipline you, is that person who really loves you. Suhag means love. Those who love us more than they will, they can chastise us. Remember, because this depends on the possessiveness, like that person's mine. That's why you chastise or discipline. I have to discipline this person, chastise him, because he's mine. So in Bengali, they say, if you love a person so much, then for his benefit, you will chastise him. So, Lalita Devi, she has so much love and affection for Srimati Radhika. So, the first sloka we see. So how much love and affection Lalita Devi has in her heart for Radha Mukunda? So if they even sweat a little bit in the time of their meeting, then Lalita Devi starts fanning them. If Srimati Radhika feels just a little bit tired, immediately Lalita sees this and she indicates to the other sakis. Serve Srimati Radhika. Page 88, last sloka, translation. I offer obeisances unto the haughty Shilalita Devi, who is the charming repository of qualities such as beauty, sweetness, and gravity, who is engaged in wiping away the glittering drops of perspiration from the lotus feet of Shirada Madhav, and who is perpetually immersed in the most elevated mellows of Sohardaras, undivided absorption in fulfilling the heart's desire of her intimate friend, Shrimati Radhika. Lalita Devi has so much bhava for Shrimati Radhika. So even higher than her own life here. Like Lalita has so much love and affection, more possessiveness for Shrimati Radhika, so much possessiveness. So that shloka we're reciting from the Lalitashtakam. Page 89, let's look. Krishna is a cheater. He makes a promise and he does not fulfill his promise. Krishna told Shrimati Radhika, hey Radhe, today in the night time I'll meet you in this specific kunja. Which kunja? Oh, I'll meet you in the Keshava kunja tonight. Or I'll meet you in the Harit Kunja. So Krishna is indicating somehow, by indicating, like hinting with other words. Krishna is telling where they'll meet and what time. Like for example, if Krishna all the time he's caressing his own hair, the sakis, they realize that Krishna wants to meet them in the Keshava Kunja. He will meet them in the Keshava Kunja. Krishna sometimes is moving some greenish leaf with his hand. The sakis understand Krishna is wanting to communicate, saying that they will meet in the Harit Kunja, you know, near the entrance of Vrindavana. After Monkey Bihari, you'll see it's written Harit Kunja. Now many things in Vrindavana changed, but still Vrindavana, it was the place of the pastimes of Krishna. So Jogamaya arranged so many kunjas at that time. So indicating, like hinting, Krishna would say where they would meet. So that Chandravali, the opposite party, would not understand. Because Chandravali is also nothing less. Chandravali sent some spies also. She sent some spies to investigate where Radha and Krishna they would meet. She's nothing less. She's also clever. Just like in the ancient times. Only the king had many spies. But some queens, they're also very intelligent and they also had some spies. To know the informations. There's a story in the Ramayana. Ramachandra was thinking, oh, what should I do? Because he went everywhere, Ramachandra, and he saw how people were speaking many bad things about Sita Devi. He went in disguise, he saw how the subjects, they were criticizing Sita Devi and like suspecting that she was not chaste and many things. So Rama was thinking, what can I do? What should I do? Because before sitting on the throne, Ram had promised that he would do everything for the happiness of the subjects. I'll do everything for the subjects' happiness. If it's necessary, even I will give up my own wife. He had promised this. Sita Devi was thinking, why my husband is in this condition? Sita Devi saw Ram was like strange, behaving strangely. So Sita Devi sent her spies to get to know what was going on. So Sita Devi come before Ram even told her, and she told, hey Prabhu, don't worry, I will go to the forest. So people say that Rama sent Sita to the forest, but if you analyze deeply, and if you study many Ramayanas, you would see that actually Sita herself, she went for the happiness of her husband and the kingdom. Actually, Ramachandra, so this, but this is all lie, everything is a lie. Let them speak. We have our pure relationship and that's it. Ram told her. Ravan didn't even kidnap you. He only took this Chaya Sita, not you. Another point, even if he had taken you, you made the test in the fire before I took you back and everything. So your purity was already established. People don't want to believe, don't want to accept. And then, okay, you got married in Delhi. Then you go to Mathura. Who is this person? Oh, he's my husband. We didn't see your wedding, so marry again. Then you go to Calcutta. We got married in Delhi. I didn't see. How possible he's your husband? Marry again. So you have to marry 10 times. All your life you're only marrying and marrying all over and over again. Nowadays, the government says that it's a court marriage. Like you can just show like the legal marriage in the paper that the person is your wife, isn't it? Do you understand? So what I'm saying is that Sita Devi herself told to Ramchandra, when you sat on the throne before, you had promised that you'd all your ancestors, they were witness of your vow. Then Ramachandra, he didn't say anything, he was silent, silence. Then Lakshman sent Sita to the ashram of Valmiki in the forest. So why am I speaking all these things? Because okay, Krishna is a cheater. He'll promise something to you, but then actually he's going to the Kunj of Chandravali. He should fulfill his promise, but he didn't. He doesn't. So there's a beautiful katha behind the story. So Krishna, he didn't take any sakha along. He went alone in the dark night. Krishna was just walking somewhere, going somewhere, and Chandravali thought, which kunja Krishna is going today? So Chandravali sent to her spies to follow Krishna, to stalk Krishna, to see where he was going. And then she realized, Krishna is going to the kunja to meet Srimati Radhika. Then a friend of Chandravali, Padma, she, when Krishna was coming on that way, in the middle, this friend of Chandravali, she's laid on the floor, and like Krishna just suddenly touched her with the feet like this, like then, who are you? I'm the friend of Chandravali, I'm Padma. What happened? Krishna, my friend Chandravali, today she's so sick. She's sick. She cannot even stand up. So Krishna himself had to lift the friend of Chandravali, Padma. Padma said, just for a little bit of time, just very quickly, come and see my friend Chandravali. By seeing her, she'll be cured from all the disease. She's fainting all the time. Who? Chandravali. So Krishna thought, okay, I'll go quickly, okay. So he went. So you know, you get like, just like a rat. If the rat is caught in the like the trap, you cannot even, he'll never be, you know, like there's some device, like a rat trap. If the rat is caught into that, he cannot escape, for the mouses, you know, small rats. Very, very difficult to come out of the trap. He becomes like really bound by that. So Krishna went to the Kunja of Chandravali, and she was like making him stay more and more and more, and Krishna was getting late to see Srimati Radhika. And Srimati Radhika herself, with her own hands, she was decorating the Kunja, because today my dear Govinda will come to my Kunja. So Chandravali didn't even decorate her Kunja to receive Krishna, because she was pretending she was sick. So if somebody is sick, it should not decorate anything. You can see. So the actors, so I think they're saying, like before he saw some drama of this Leela, I think some kids were doing this. Chandravali doesn't have Madhyata Bhav or anything, but Srimati Radhika has Madhyata Bhav. Krishna is mine. So if your own sakis, Srimati Radhika was decorating the Keshava Kunja with beautiful flowers. Each flower, Srimati Radhika was manifesting one mood of her heart. Srimati Radhika, with her own hands, she was decorating that Kunja. Actually, she was expressing her moods while she was decorating the Kunja. Like nowadays, someone writes like with the hand, like I love you, and makes some many kinds of, I don't know, like sayings and beautiful drawings. And also she ornamented with many lights, like geeks, I don't know, lights. So also with petals of flowers. She decorated the Kunja so well. She put lit candles, like geeks everywhere. Swarna
chari taraf dipak jala bhi diya aur phir iske jo hai phir ek ek karke wo bichh raha tha kya na.
So there's one kind of tree also, kadamba tree. So there's a way of decorating the kunja, special way. So with many kinds of flowers like Madhavi, Malati, Jui, with beautiful fragrant flowers, she decorated the Kunja. There's only one door of the Kunja. And that door was so well decorated also, so beautifully. And there was a beautiful place for the sitting of Radha and Krishna in the middle. Manjaris and Sakis, they are doing this. They are making the bed of Radha and Krishna. Vishnu Chakravarti explains in the shloka. So beautiful this flower, this bed makes of petals of made of petals of flowers, so soft. There's a very soft thin, some like a cloth, like a shiny cloth. So that the petals will not like, how to say, like trouble Radha and Krishna. Like put some cloth on top, very fine and nice. The flowers are very beautiful when you see, but the same flower, if you cover that flower with a very fine cloth, like suppose a red cloth, like kind of transparent, the very fine, that flower which is underneath will be even more beautiful and more shiny and amazing, isn't it? So they also cover the bed of petals of flowers with this cloth also, for Radha and Krishna. So the Sakis, they do the Kunja Seva so well. So Jiva Goswami wrote, to clean the temple is actually serve the Kunja. What is Mandir Marjan? We see how the person is like sweeping the floor of the temple, is cleaning the temple. But for the high class devotees, actually he's serving in the Kunja. So we sing for Gurudeva, that Gurudeva is like also serving the temple, means like this actually in the Kunja. So Srimati Radhika, she was decorating beautiful Kunja for Krishna. And now the Manjari is also helping, so nice. So beautifully decorating, they are waiting for Krishna. When will Krishna come? When will he come? They are also sitting near the entrance. Lalita and the Sakis, also they were present. Today a very special meeting of the meeting of Radha and Krishna will take place today. But Krishna didn't arrive. So the more the time would go by, the more the mind of Srimati Radhika would be so disturbed. More her mind would be disturbed. Because if you have sneha and priti, love and affection, there's one more symptom. Which symptom?
पर और एक लक्षण होता है, पर और एक लक्षण होता है, क्या होता है उसमें, ना दुश्चिंता आ जाता है।
So you worry about who you love. You worry so much and you're thinking bad things happen maybe. So Krishna is getting late. So Srimati Radhika is afraid. Maybe he stepped on something, some thorn. Or maybe Krishna is coming alone, that he doesn't have any friend with him and something happened. Because in the middle of the night, Krishna is walking alone. Srimati Radhika is worrying, thinking so many bad things. So Shastra explains, one of the symptoms of love is thinking bad things about the person you love. You love, like you're worrying too much, thinking maybe bad things happened. You see how high is the love of Srimati Radhika. Oh, Krishna, I was supposed to be here by now. He's coming alone. Oh, maybe Krishna stepped on some thorn and Krishna, who will take out, remove this thorn from Krishna's feet, foot? Oh my, and who will make a wound in Krishna's foot or... So Srimati Radhika is worrying so much. She doesn't think about anything else. She's just worrying about Krishna. All the negative thoughts are coming. No, sorry, positive. The mood of Srimati, like her mood is so high. Maybe he fell during the way, he fainted. Who will help him? Or what happened? So Srimati Radhika is thinking like this. She's worrying and thinking like in auspicious things. And many kinds of moods also come in the heart, like nirbed. One symptom of prem is that the more the prem is condensed, thicker, so the more the person will think about all these like inauspicious things and like worrying so much. So since Srimati Radhika worrying in this way, anxious, and so Lalita Devi indicated Rupa Manjari Gati Manjari, go search for Krishna. Search for him and check where is he. So this is all positive, no but negative. Okay, Krishna went to the Kunja of Chandravali. They're not thinking. They thought, oh, Krishna will come to our Kunja today. Nobody knew Krishna was in another in the Chandravali's Kunja. So nobody knew Krishna would come to the Keshava Kunja. Because nobody knew. The opposite party, Chandravali, didn't know. So, because they knew that when they spoke to Krishna about it, nobody realized because they only indicated with hints and everything. So Lalita Devi told Rupa Manjari Rati Manjari to check where Krishna was. So they searched all over Vrindavan and they didn't find Krishna. And then Rati Manjari said, let's check the last place. Let's go to the place of Chandravali. Let's go to the Sakhi Kunja and check there. Let's go to the Sakistali to see if Krishna is there. So they came near the Sakikunja and oh my, they felt the smell of Krishna's body. The fragrance of Krishna's body. This fragrance came into their nostrils. Oh my, this cheater, Krishna, today he's in Sakikunja. Oh no, Sakistali. He's come to the Sakis Tali. So the word Saki is not good. So we're saying Saki, but you see? Sakis Tali, Saki Kunja, oh no. We don't like. So Krishna has entered the Kunja of Chandravali Saki. So how Krishna will come out? So how, if the snake is inside like a basket or a hole, how can you take out the snake? If you beat the snake will come more under, like, if you also throw something, the snake will try to run away from you, like inside the hole, it will come under and under the snake. But if you throw hot water into the cave of the snake, then the snake will come out. Like if you try to take the snake with your hand, the snake will bite you. If you try to remove it, the snake will like try to like dodge from you and also cannot come out. But if you throw hot water, then the snake will come out. So the manjari is from outside the kundal, they started screaming, "Hey Krishna, Krishna, where are you? A great demon came, arrived in Braj." Our Sakhi Srimati Radhika is suffering because of this demon. This demon is going to attack Srimati Radhika. Oh Govinda Pran Priyatam Govindo, please, you can protect us. Just like also we say, Gopi Git. So this mood of Gopi Git is like this. Oh Krishna, when there is some problem, calamity and some demon in Braj, you always protect the Brajavasis. So this is Loka from the Gopi Git. So hey Govinda. So Rati Manjari, they were screaming with very piteous voice, like, Govinda, a terrible demon has come to Braj and is creating a havoc. Like, sometimes some demons came, like, that one they killed. Sorry, he killed. At Arishtasur, and many demons have come. Krishna killed many demons. You've killed many demons. So they will also... You will not protect our Swamini Srimati Radhika. Actually, the Manjari, she meant that which demon has come? The Viraha Rupi Asur, the Asur of separation from you, is what is torturing Srimati Radhika today. Hey Govinda, you, please protect her and give your darshan to her. Krishna, he got the point. He understood what they meant. But what to do? Then Krishna told Chandravali, Chandre, my mom, she had told me to pick up some stuff, but I forgot. Actually, my mom is waiting for me. My mom is waiting for me. So you have to go away with some pretext, some excuse, right? Go away with some excuse. So Krishna said, actually, I need to do something that my mom's asked me. My mom told me to do some stuff. Later on, when I come back to your kunja, don't be upset, okay? I'll go and come back, real quick. It will take only 2 seconds. How much time does it take to go and come back? Hey, Chandre, I tell you something. But if I will be late to come back, don't worry, okay? Tomorrow we'll meet, no problem, okay? Krishna is also very expert to speak. He's Dhira Lalita Naik, you know. This is a symptom of this hero, Dhira Lalita Naik. Bakpatuta means very expert how to speak. So when he speaks anything, you believe in him. Like you just give in and believe what he's saying. So they told, okay, Govinda, go. So being like, after Chandravali allowing him to go, so Krishna came out, went away. Then Rati Manjari caught him. Cheater! So they will take you to the court. Where? To the court. You'll be like, they will decide about you. Like the judge will decide what is your like a penalty, and you have to accept the penalty because of your bad deeds. So Krishna completely controlled by the beloved. So he came so ashamed. He was caught red-handed, right? So he was caught red-handed, wasn't it? So he was ashamed. He couldn't say, oh, I was somewhere else. He didn't have an alibi, right? He was caught red-handed, could not lie. So what to say? Okay. When he came back, brought by the Manjaris. Srimati Radhika, from far, she indicated. So Radha Manjari somehow brought Krishna, seeing Krishna, Srimati Radhika. She understood what happened and she thinks, I'm so simple and direct, but he's not like that. Like, if you think ghee will be direct with you, actually when the ghee is solid, you cannot take out the ghee from the jar with your straight finger. You have to bend your finger to take the ghee out of the jar, isn't it? To take out the ghee from the jar, you need bend your finger, isn't it? Like your finger must be like in bended position to take out the solid ghee from the jar. So like, Srimati Radhika told her sakis, everyone get away, get out. We've decorated this kunja for whom? We decorated for that person, but that person didn't come. All our endeavors were useless. Everything was useless that we've done today here. Srimati Radhika was angry man. So Srimati Radhika herself closed the door of the kunja. Even the manjaris could not stay inside, everybody had to get out. Srimati Radhika said, everybody get out, and she was alone in the kunja, sitting alone. You've seen that picture where Srimati Radhika is like with her hand on her cheeks and she is sitting alone and just crying. So sometimes she's with her nails, she's like on the floor, like I'd say, like caressing, not caressing, like risking the floor with her nails. Lalita Vishaka Manjaris, everyone is out of the kunja and Srimati Radhika was alone inside. Then suddenly Krishna came. When Krishna came, then the sakis told Krishna, Krishna, you're a cheater, get out. Today Srimati Radhika is very angry. Manini. So Krishna fell again and again to the feet of the sakis. I accept my offense. Please forgive me. I know I did a mistake. So again and again. Seeing Krishna in this way, so humble, and Srimati Radhika, she saw from this like small windows, let's say like this, I don't know how proper word. Srimati Radhika lifted her veil and she saw what Krishna was feeling. Seeing Krishna so humble, seeing from inside the kunja, Srimati Radhika saw what Krishna was doing outside. Then Srimati Radhika could not resist. She thought, okay. Anyway, what happened, but his mind, he's falling to the feet of my sakis. I'll forgive him. I'll make up to him. Make up with him. Then Lalita saw Srimati Radhika and understood that Srimati Radhika was ready to forgive Krishna. Then Lalita Devi, at the time, she raised her finger and told this shloka. Which shloka? Srimati Radhika, he is durta, he is a cheater. Don't display your mood of gentle submission to him. Instead, always be contrary in all circumstances. He's very guileful. Like the hypocrite people, they are speaking very sweet words, but in their heart, they are full of venom and poison. Their heart is full of poison. Krishna, he's a black inside and outside. He's a cheater. So Srimati Lalita Devi, she's pointing with her finger and she's saying, hey Radhe, always keep your Vama Bhav, contrary mood, in all circumstances. Don't give in. Hey Radhe, what is the cause of your being criticized? Being unchaste is because of Krishna. If you forgive him, he will continue doing the same things. No. not at all. You should give in and apologize and forgive him. Always be opposite to him, like a contrary mode in all circumstances. Listen to me. So Lalita Devi, she's pointing out her finger like this and telling Srimati Radhika, you should not give up your Vamya Bhav. Hey Radhe, I tell you again and again, listen to me. Listen to me. Listen to my instruction. Listen to my beneficial words. It's for your benefit that I'm saying all these things. I love you, that's why I'm telling you. I have love and affection for you. So she's instructing Srimati Radhika. She's telling Srimati Radhika to continue being angry with Krishna. So time's up, but what is the continuation of this story? Okay. So Srimati Radhika, okay, she decides to continue man. Before Srimati Radhika thought, okay, I'll give darshan to Krishna, what's past is past. I'll go out, come out of the kunja and meet him. Because Srimati Radhika is so simple. They say in Vrindavana, Boli Gopi Radhe Radhe. Boli means very simple. Srimati Radhika forgets very easily everything, you know. Just seeing Krishna, just by seeing him, Srimati Radhika forgets all his offenses, everything he did bad. So these modes of Govinda, seeing her, everyone who sees him like becomes like simple-minded, like Sarav. This is the specialty of Krishna Darshan. So just by seeing Govinda, everything is like cleared up, no problem. Like, I give an example to you. The sandalwood tree is so fragrant, even the bubble tree, like a thorny tree nearby the sandalwood tree, also become fragrant. Just because she's near the sandalwood tree. Many times the snakes, they live also near in the sandalwood tree because they like that smell. But the snake can never touch her venom in the sandalwood tree. Like there's also a snake around the Shiva's neck, but that snake, does not bite or anything bad to Shiva. This is the influence of the association of sadhu, of the sadhu. The powerful personalities, the sadhus, they change these bad people. They can change their nature. So what I want to say is that Srimati Radhika, she has this mood. Oh, Krishna is a cheater. Okay. Like, hypocrite. I forgive him. Okay, whoever he is, he's my beloved. So, he's the love of my life, no matter what. He's the love of my life, no matter what. He's Govinda. Whether he gives me darshan or doesn't give me darshan. If he Padarata means like he steps on me, or if he embraces me. He's a devotee, even though he may be enjoying with other women right in front of me. But yeah, no matter what, he's the beloved of my life, the love of my life. To the mood of Srimati Radhika, who can describe her love for Krishna? So Srimati Radhika says, I'll forgive Prana Govinda. But Lalita, she told her, no, you cannot. In front of Lalita, like, because I told Lalita, she's like, she's the supreme, she's controlling everyone, Lalita. So that's why she wanted to give in, but after Lalita told her, she again like decided to continue the man being in view of Krishna, and so these beautiful lilies are going on in the kunja, where the Supreme Lord, who is so worshipped by even Brahma and great demigods, 100 billions and infinite Brahmas, they are falling to the feet of Krishna. All the Digpals, protective directions, they are coming to the feet of Krishna, performing many prayers to Krishna, and this Krishna now is in this condition. This Swami Bhagavan, now Swami Bhagavan is Srimati Radhika is inside the kunja. Srimati Radhika very far. Lalita Vishaka also are not there. There are small manjaris, and Krishna is falling to the feet of these small manjaris. And Krishna is falling at their feet, putting his head at her feet. Their feet. Very humble, asking them, hey, manjaris, sakis, please help me out. And bring my submission to the Srimati Radhika. But Sakya say, tell Krishna, today is not possible at all. Not even we can come inside the kunja today. What to speak of others? I told, no, that Srimati Radhika had told that day. She had herself closed the door of that kunja that day. So, and Lalita also had again and again pointing out and ordering Srimati Radhika, no. Oh, one chase one Kalankini Srimati Radhika, you should not give in. You should continue being angry with Krishna. Don't just continue like this. Okay. But after some time, time is up, no? Okay, arrange the arati. So what to do in the end, right? Krishna saw he had no other solution. He tried with the mandala, is not possible. Then Krishna tried with Lalita and Vishaka. So they told Srimati Radhika after some time, okay, stop the man. But the man was already too high. Srimati Radhika said, I won't give up my man. Lalita Vishaka were like, okay, night is light, it's very late at now. Kunja Bangalila. You know, this lila in the kunja will be finished soon. You have to sleep, you have to go back to your house, you have to stop the lila in the kunja now. But she had girls feeling so man, she said no. So much man, she said no. You told me to be man, today I'll not give in, I'll continue in the man. Lalita Vishaka did try to make Srimati Radhika change her mind, but Srimati Radhika was not. So Srimati Radhika wouldn't change her mind now. So Krishna was like helpless. He also left. But look, exactly when Krishna left the kunja, the door of the kunja, Srimati Radhika couldn't tolerate it. She couldn't. So she came to the door of the kunja and she started crying. She got the hand of Lalita Vishaka and told, where's my beloved Govinda? Where, without him I cannot survive. Lalita Vishaka told her, hey Radhe, we have just told you that you should stop being angry, give up the man and everything, but you didn't listen to us. You were like Durjaya man, very difficult to pacify man, angry. So Krishna, he went away helpless, like hopeless. So in this Bengali Kirtan explains, Srimati Radhika herself told, Srimati Radhika is saying to her friends, Lalita Vishaka, yeah, I was feeling man, I was angry, yes. But all my friends, you knew what was in my heart. All my friends, you are my friends, my sakis, you know my heart. So externally, I was like very angry with Krishna, but my heart is so soft, just like a coconut. You know, coconut is externally hard, isn't it? But inside the coconut, it's so soft. So Srimati Radhika is saying to her friends, oh my friends, you are, oh girls, you are my friend, you know my heart, so that's why. So Krishna had come to my kunja to meet me. Okay, I was angry, but After some time, my anger will be dissolved, like my mind will be pacified. So why did you allow him to go away? Narita and Vishaka said, why? But we tried to tell you to give up your mind, but you didn't listen to us. Srimati Radhika told, did you understand the Bengali verse? No. Srimati Radhika is telling, hey Lalita Abhishekhe. Okay, Hari came to my kunja. Why did you allow him to go away? Why? So what should we have done? Prahari means? He should be like a security guard. He could have stayed as like a security guard sitting in front of my kunja. When my man would be finished, then I would meet him. So in this way there are many leelas. So without the sakis you don't have any destination. These pastimes of Radha Krishna are very confidential. Devotees of Dasa, Sakya, Vatsala, they don't have eligibility for these pastimes. Only the Sakis, they create these pastimes, they organize these pastimes, and they relish these pastimes, and they have access to these pastimes. Only the Sakis. Radharana Samvada, Chaitanya Charitamrita explains.